What was Master M.F. Hussain like? You know, just...
Oh, he's wonderful. I was talking, having a conversation with him about something, and I said, you know, I'm really bored, or something like that. And he said, how can you get bored? You know, I'm 88 years old and I don't get bored. There's so much to life, and there's not a moment. I don't understand how you can be bored. And I thought that was fascinating, because he just had so much passion, and he had so much that he still wanted to do and discover, and it's fantastic. I mean,
and if at 88 and now he's 94 and he's still so articulate and with it, I mean, if we can be like that, we're blessed.
If we can be like that when we're 30, then we're blessed as well. So,
okay. What is the biggest delusion of grandeur that you've encountered, you know, ever since you've stepped into the industry?
I sometimes think that fame is not all that it's made out to be. It's fun. It has its moments and its perks, but it's not what you imagine it to be.
What has been your most humbling moment?
I think Rang De Basanti. Every time we visited the theaters, you know, people were crying, and I think Rang De Basanti spoiled me at some level, because I said, this is really easy. You know, you make a movie which you have lots of fun doing, and it's a commercial success, and it becomes a movement. So I don't know what people are complaining about. You know, movies are really simple. And what I didn't realize at that point is it happens probably once in a lifetime, and if you're lucky, twice, thrice.
Do you fear that it may never happen to you again like that?
No, I'm just happy that it happened, you know. I think, you know, when I look at a lot of other people's careers, they've been around for 15, 20 years, given huge hits and, you know, been part of really successful films. But it's very rarely that somebody's been a part of a film that becomes a movement, you know, becomes more than just a film.